Hello friends, in this video tutorial we discuss about the page context implicit object of the page context class. Let's see with practical. Here I am using the Eclipse as a IDE, and first I click on the file and then new, and then take a dynamic web project. A dialog box will be displayed here, and simply I need to write my project name, and I'm giving my project name as a page context demo, and click on the next. Check the generate web.xml deployment descriptor and click on the finish. My project displayed under the project explorer. Look here, this is the page context demo, that is my project, and I simply right click on my web content. A pop-up menu will be displayed here, and simply I click on the new and take a JSP file, giving here my file name as index.jsp, and press enter. My index.jsp page is created here, and simply I am taking here a form tag and action attribute and passing here welcome.jsp and press enter. I am using here a pre-formatted tag, and simply I write here enter the user name, and taking here a tag input type equal text, and giving here the name as a username, and close it. I am taking another input type as a submit, and giving here the value equals to go, and close it. Okay, and save it. Look here, I'm taking a form tag and action attribute and providing the URL of welcome.jsp page, and in the next line I'm using the pre-formatted tag. We are using for the pre-tag, if you write any code here, it is a display onto the screen. Don't need to write table, tr, td, etc. So I am using here the pre-tag, and in the next line I am write here the enter the username, taking here the input type as a text and giving here the name as a username. User enter any name into this checkbox and click on the submit button. The action simply redirect to welcome.jsp. So we need to create a welcome.jsp page. First I right click on the web content and click on the new and take a JSP file. I am simply giving here my file name as a welcome.jsp. Press enter. My welcome.jsp page is created here, and simply I am using the scriptlet tag and declaring a variable string name equal request dot get parameter, and passing here a parameter name as a username and terminated with semicolon, and calling here out implicit object and method print, and simply I write here username plus and providing the space and variable name terminated with semicolon, and here I am calling the page context implicit object and set attribute, passing here the user, and here I am passing the variable name, and I am giving here the third argument as a page context class, and passing here the isco as a session, isco, and terminated with semicolon, and save it. And here I am taking an anchor tag and write here the href equal second dot JSP, and simply write here the display and save it. Look here, I am using a scripted tag, declaring a variable string as a name and calling here the implicit object request and get parameter method and passing here the parameter as a username. And look here, this is my parameter name. When the user enter the any username into the text box, user click on the submit button, the control come here, and with the help of get parameter we store the value into the name variable, username into the name variable, and with the help of out implicit object calling here the method, simply I write here within the double quote username as it is print onto the screen. With the help of this double quote provide the space, and with the help of this variable name simply print the username. And in the next line I am using here the page context implicit object and set attribute method to set the value. It needs three parameters. Simply I am giving here the user as a name, comma, here the object name as a name, means I want to set the value that is coming from the index.jsp page, and then comma, and calling here the page context class and giving here the scope as a session. Here you can give four scope: page scope, request scope, session scope, and application scope. I am using here the session scope, means all the requests coming from the same user, and the value you can get anywhere in your project. You can also use the application scope, that is the value getting from all the users requested, and the first is the page scope, and we are using for the page scope, it is only work to this page, any welcome.jsp page to get the value. So I want to get this value to the second page, so I am using here the session scope, and here my scriptlet tag closed, and taking here the anchor tag and passing here the URL as a second.jsp, and write here the display. When the user click on the display, the value stored into the page context I want to display onto the second page. So I just need to create a second.jsp page, and I right click, take a new JSP file, and giving here my file name as a second.jsp and press enter, and simply I am giving here the h1 label heading display the value using page context implicit object, and press enter using here a scriptlet tag and declaring a variable string name equal page context dot get attribute, and simply I need to write my name, and I'm simply giving here the name as a user, come here, comma, and page context dot session scope. I am providing the scope and terminated with semicolon. I need here to type cost to a string, and just I am write here the string and save it, because the page context is the implicit object, so you cannot assign any value of the object to any variable. So I am type cost here into the string, and calling here the out dot print out implicit object, and method calling here the print, and simply I write here the user name providing the space and plus, simply I'm giving the variable name and save it. Okay, page context dot get attribute. Get attribute is the method that take the two argument name and scope. I am simply giving here the session scope, because I am giving here also the session scope. And come here to second page, and the page context simply assign the value to the name, and with the help of print method we print the name onto the screen. And I simply right click on the index.jsp, run on server, and click on the next, and then finish. My index.jsp page is displayed by the browser onto the screen, and where you simply see the one text box and one button. When the user enter the username and click on the submit button, then control redirect to welcome.jsp. It is taking little time. Okay, and simply I am giving my username as a Ram, and click on the go. It come to second page. Username I am giving here the Ram, and this is the anchor tag, and simply I click on the display. It will redirect to second.jsp and simply print the value, display the value using page context implicit object username as a Ram. Thank you friends, please subscribe my channel and like my video. Thanks for watching my video. First I closing video, I want to some changes. You look here, I am come to welcome.jsp, and simply I am change the scope page dot page context dot page scope, and save it. Come to second page, and also giving here the page scope. The difference is that the page scope only work for this page, so it can display the null value here. Let's see with practical. I save it and run it. Run on server. Click on the next and finish. I refresh it and write here the RAM and click on the go. Here display the RAM, but when we click on the display, it will print the null, because this is the page scope that is work for welcome.jsp. You can write or you can get the value of the page context to anywhere in this page, not to another page. Thank you friends, please subscribe my channel and like my video. Thanks for watching my video. Thanks a lot.